Was he a Nazi or was he a scientist? Most would like to believe he was a scientist, although many feel Wernher von Braun was responsible for the deaths of thousands. Even if one feels his actions towards slave labor were to blame, the fact remains that Wernher von Braun was responsible for the space age becoming a reality in this century. Von Braun was named by Life magazine as one of the 100 most important Americans of the 20th century, touting him as the man who launched the greatest adventure of all, a journey to the moon. But others would ask, at what cost? Wernher von Braun was born to Baron von Braun and Emmy Quistorp on March 23, 1912, in a town in eastern Germany province of Posen. From childhood, Wernher revealed an interest in both science and music. Even at a young age, Wernher was a visionary man and decided that his life goal was to help turn the wheel of time. When this picture was taken, no one could have imagined the career that lay ahead of him as a pioneer of rocketry. At age 11, he enrolled in a school that had been established two centuries earlier by Frederick the Great. There he flunked math and physics, that of course he would later excel in. His mother once gave him a handful of old books and a telescope that he erupted his interest into rocketry. One book that captured the young boy's attention was written by Hermann Oberth's called The Rocket into Planetary Space. However, von Braun soon learned that he would have to excel in mathematics to even understand the concepts and principles in the book. Even during these younger years of his life, von Braun was experimenting with rockets and propulsion. He once strapped a cluster of solid rocket motors to a wagon and shot it down a crowded street. Many in the crowd were not amused. The next step for the 18-year-old Wernher von Braun was to enter in the Berlin district of Charlottenburg. All the while, his interest in astronomy and space travel kept growing. He had become acquainted with astronautics pioneer Hermann Oberth, who was the author of the book he once read that transformed him into a model student. After they were invited to watch a rocket demonstration, members of the Army Reichswehr at Army Ordnance failed to be impressed with anyone or anything other than the young Wernher von Braun. The VFR members had hoped to gain funding from the Army to continue their experiments, but it was 1932, and Adolf Hitler was in power. Nazi Germany was going to ban all rocketry experiments and discussion outside of the German military. On November 1, 1932, von Braun signed a contract with the Reichswehr to conduct research leading to the development of rockets as military weapons. In this capacity, he would work for Captain Walter. His association with Walter would last for over a decade. A secure, isolated location was suggested by Wernher's mother. It was called Nemunda. This wooded, quiet part of Germany was located on the Baltic Sea at the mouth of the river. The army poured money into the co-development of Nemunda. A huge complex of buildings for housing, testing, manufacturing, and development were constructed. During these fast-moving early development stages of Nemunda's growth, the multitude of German scientists and engineers were well served by the young and resourceful von Braun. His ability to put the right personnel in key positions and von Braun's own exuberance for the V2 project was key in Nemunda's success. The V2 was the first missile used in warfare and a significant advancement in rocket technology. It was used against the Allies primarily as a terror weapon. Because it was so inaccurate, it was only able to be used against civilians who had no defense of it as it came streaming down from the upper atmosphere. A frightful event occurred in mid-March 1944 when von Braun was arrested by the German police and imprisoned. The alleged crime was that von Braun had declared his main interest in developing the V2 was for space travel, not as a weapon. It was his personal intervention of munitions and Hitler that gained von Braun's release from jail. Beginning in September of 1944, V2s were launched against Paris, London, Antwerp, and other targets. During the summer of 1945, interrogation by the Allies continued. The Americans soon offered von Braun and some 120 key members of his team a 6-month contract to work for the Army Ordnance in the United States. The offer was accepted. Soon von Braun and 6 colleagues were on their way to the United States. It was in Alabama that the Germans eventually gained their American citizenship. Soon the space race with the Soviet Union created an urgent need for von Braun's help. If you think about it, everything involving spaceships, rockets, and missiles all came about because of Wernher von Braun. Even though our technology has become far more advanced, we are still using his basic principles with the science behind the rockets. Many of his basic designs have even been put into most of our very own rockets today. Wernher has been known to be called Rocket Man of War and Peace. This is because his inventions and designs with rockets have been both used for many positive effects, as well as negatives. As head of the NASA space program from 1960 through 1970, he pushed for success in everything. He always wanted to be the first in space, the first on the moon, the first in everything. His dream to help mankind set foot on the moon became a reality on July 16, 1969, when Apollo 11 landed on the moon. His very own designs were used and a key in this major event that finally put America ahead of not only the space race, but since then has put America in an advancement in rocketry. After he delivered the first man to the moon, he was instrumental in developing the Saturn 1B, which lifted Skylab, the world's first space station, into orbit. But of course, Wernher did not want to stop there. He wanted Mars. Wernher made his first engineering analysis of a manned mission to Mars in 1948. He published his calculations in 1952, and he subsequently reached a wide audience in Cuyler's magazine, a series of books, and the Walt Disney television program. His involvement with the Mars project has been more beneficial today as it was then. His rocket design today was a key element that has been left behind that we used when the US finally landed on Mars. Unfortunately, there were and there are still many out there who have used rockets and missiles to bring many hardships. Rocketry has been taken advantage of and used for destruction in many events, not just in his time, but today. The first sign that his involvement in rocketry has been taken advantage of was during the Cold War. Here, there was the potential of nuclear warheads present that posed a big threat on many countries. These rockets enable bad countries to be able to attack on many other countries. Today, Israel and Palestine are fighting with each other. For the past many years, the cause of so much aggravation and destruction in both of their lands has started because of the power and the want for destructive and powerful rockets and missiles. In a press conference in 1967, Wernher stated,
"It is simply unfair to make us scientists and engineers responsible for the cruelties of modern wars. Should Einstein, when writing down his famous formula on the relation between matter and energy contents, have laid aside the pencil with trembling hand because he had the vision of releasing unimaginable amounts of atomic energy? Should we today stop our activities to conquer space just because rockets and airplanes can be used for military purposes?"
Von Braun's life ended on June 16, 1977 of colon cancer in Alexandria, Virginia at the age of 65. He was buried in the same city at the Ivy Hill Cemetery. Many today believe that Von Braun should not have been celebrated as a hero. They feel he turned a blind eye toward what was happening to slave laborers in Germany. While all of this may be true, Von Braun's work on the rocket was his passion throughout his whole life, not just during the war. Though his life had been cut off, his time put into rocketry will always remain as we continue to honor his works, designs, and inventions that brought the U.S. so many advances, both in his time, but especially in today's world. A year before Wernher's death, he once quoted,
"For man, there is no rest and no ending. He must go on, conquest beyond conquest. And when he has conquered all the depths of space and all the mysteries of time, he will be but beginning."